Hi dear viewers, welcome to YouTube channel. I'm so happy you are here, and in today's video I'm gonna talk about future perfect. But before get started, do not forget to subscribe this amazing YouTube channel about Norwegian English grammar, and do not forget to click the bell notification too. It will help you to notify when I post new videos, and also click like and share to your friends too. In addition, you can find this the videos also on Facebook by the name YouTube Education. So in our today's topic is about the future perfectum or future perfect. So before that, I will show you some illustration what we have discussed from our previous lesson and session. We have discussed about adjectives. So we know that adjectives, they help us to denote or to indicate the nouns. But in Norwegian, they have different forms or patterns. So some of the examples I showed you last week about how to make comparison using the adjectives, and also how we are going to make a bestemt adjective or decisive adjectives. Like for example, Rune høyre enn Anne. This meaning is comparison between two. Always in Norwegian, we use comparison by adding ara and n. Dyrere n, ara n. Finere, ara n. Flinkeste, this is superlative to compare from the whole. Iste. And kortere, ara n, compare with, between two. And the lille schafte, that are the bestemt form of litten. When we know that the thing, so if you want to change into bestemt or noun, we use the adjective litten, change into lille, and small also into plural form also in bestemt form. So these are the way what we have seen last day. So you can try and train also yourself in such a way. So when we come to our today's topic is all about future perfectum. But before that, we are going to categorize this future perfectum or future perfect into two: present future perfect and preteritum future perfect. So first, let's see what is the usage or when we are going to apply this present future perfectum. So we use this present future perfectum to denote an action or an event in the future, which is over, which will be over by the time another action or event occurs or happens. So this means there are two actions, but one action should have to be finished before happen the second action. So let's see in the example, and the format or the pattern also we use like skal plus ha plus perfect tense. So han skal ha snakket med dem om dette før de reiser til London. Before they travel, he should have to speak to them about the case or about the thing. And hun skal ha lest avisa før hun går på jobb. Before she leave to work, she should have to read the newspaper. So reading the newspaper, it comes before going to the work. And this skal ha levert brevet til post kontoret for de drar til sendesentrum. This meaning before delivering or before sending the letter to the post office. No, before traveling to the Sandnes center, the center of the city or downtown of the city. So they should have to deliver or they should have to send the brief to the post office. These are two things happened in the future, but the first action or the first event should have to be finished before continue or happening the second event or action. So this is the one way of usage of present future perfectum in Norwegian grammar. And the second usage is when you have a restricted time point. For example, de moha absolutat exam in en klokkatu. They should have to finish the exam within klokkatu or 2 o'clock. Un moha lever dokumentan in klokkatu. This is also limited time. Third example is they will have detailed ut factora for 12 March. Before 12 March, you should have to pay the bills. Hun skal ha space for program, before the program starts. Maybe the program starts at 9 o'clock and she is going to eat around 8 o'clock, from 8 to 9. But when the program starts, she will stop. So these are two things happen. She will eat first and then the program starts. So this is also one way of very restricted time. So this also helps us to indicate in present perfectum. The third way is to indicate about things dubious or if you are not sure. For example, this car hamot if we sent his hands, whether they will come or not, we don't know. Hans Karl has shopped, he bought the thing or not, we are not quite sure. Or Hans Karl has peace, whether he ate or not, we are not quite real or sure thing. So this also, if we are very dubious or if we have not sure, so we can use this future perfectum. The second usage is preteritum or past future perfect. Here, for example, we can use discula spisa diacome hans kula shop em bil if your men miset han yoben hans kula hari part bilen for summer fair. These are things happen in the future, in the past, but they indicate futurity. But it's not finished or it's not fulfilled, the things that happened in the future, but they were in the past. They are in the past, but not accomplished as the way that they were thinking. So this is the way how we use the fortis futurum, futurity in the past. Futurity in the past, yeah. The fourth example is Yeskulle Yarn Hasnaket Mihenne. Also, we use also Skulle or preteritum future perfectum to indicate for politeness or to kind of polite way of expressing to someone. Also we use skulle. And the other one is in conditional way also. If you are not sure or if you are not real things also, we can like imagining. Like if I were a fish, I could swim. If I were a bird, I could fly, like that. Had the less Mia kunna the habestot examine. If they read, they can pass the exam. Had the space for course will do ikha waqt sultan no. Ble do mehen e bibliothek kunna huniel padai me lexanasine. If you are with her, so she will help you. Probability. But it's a kind of condition things. They are if conditions, like in English. So this is also the way we use it in future, in preteritum, but past future conditionals. It's not real things to indicate we can use it. In the future, I will show you also more examples and to make this easy and to make you also to train and to to write with the future perfect tense. So for today, this is the way, this is the topic that I have presented to you, and I will give you also with some homework and assignment. You can try to write from 5 to 7 sentences with future perfect. And I will bring also 7 sentences in the future. Until then, wishing you all the best, and try to subscribe, share, and like, not forget. And wishing all a marvelous day, and see you next week. Have a nice day.